Established in 2009 in Singapore, Taste of India Restaurant Private Limited provides a wonderful fusion and taste from North and South India. With a wide variety of Indian cuisine, it provides fine dining, outdoor catering services, and a function hall to accommodate more than 120 packs for all kinds of events. Taste of India has established a strong support from customers in Singapore already.
My full name is Alagappan Karthik, but short form is A. Karthik. So, and I'm currently involved in multiple business, but the main focus is on F&B. So we are running Taste of India restaurant at the moment. We are basically from Chettinad. It's in South India, and to exactly say we are from Devakote, it's a place in Chettinad. I was in India for around 6 years before I came to Singapore. My dad was here like 35 years back, came in 1980. So he brought us into Singapore. Then I started my primary education in Singapore. I was not a very active kid, but quite passive, like a mom's child. I'm the first son. I have two younger brothers. So when we came, I came to Singapore in 1990. Then yeah, from then thereon, being in Singapore, I did my primary, secondary, JC. I went to NS and uni, everything in Singapore itself. Yeah. When my dad came, he's a chartered accountant, so he came as an accountant to Singapore. He was working in multiple places and mainly SATA, Tuberculosis Center in Singapore, and he was working till 1995. Before he planned to quit his job and enter into business. Before that, around 1991, he was doing import-export from India to Seychelles, Mauritius and other countries, Indian groceries and other products. Then 1995, he fully quit his job and came full into business, and he started South Indian Restaurant, the first F&B shop in 1995. Then for the past 20 years, he's in this industry. So from young, when I was growing up, I'm seeing the industry and how it grows and what happens and all the, you know, pros and cons of the industry. Actually, after graduation, I wanted to do business. So at that point in time, I was not clear what business I want to do, whether I want to start up an entirely new business on my own or to run a family business. Then I was thinking, so I thought, okay, might as well, you know, join a job, then maybe do MBA, where I will get some, you know, vision, like what I actually want to do. And because starting a business is never an easy thing to do. And there are a lot of industries, a lot of fields, and you need to see where's your interest, your passion in. So that's why I wanted to have some time before entering the business. But from young, I always wanted to do business. So I did my computer engineering. So I thought, okay, and I got a job in IBM on campus itself. So after graduation, immediately I entered IBM. So I was working there. I was happy with my job, but always, you know, to do business, being your own boss is there in my mind. So I wanted to do MBA, then I went to Stanford. Then after completing this course, and they also advised, okay, you already have a family business, so give it a shot. So once you enter into some kind of business which is already there, so it's easier for you to enter and succeed also. Never an easy thing to succeed any business, but there's already established business, so it's easier to run it than starting a fresh business. So they say, okay, then I decided, okay, might as well do a family business, have some exposure, have some contacts. Then, you know, my dad, like that, he started in one industry, then he ventured into other industry. Like he started in an import-export trading, then he went to F&B. The F&B itself, we franchise. So now we have a non-vegetarian restaurant, we have a vegetarian restaurant, we do have a bakery. So keep on expanding that field itself. Then we also have a departmental store, provision store and all those things. So my dad doesn't focus in any one field or one industry, so he likes to expand. So I thought, okay, might as well, you know, start with this for the start, be there for a couple of years, then, you know, then see where you want to go, or you want to start into a new industry, new business, or you want to expand this business. So that's why I took over the family business. When I took over the business, seeing the business and running a business is two different things. So I've been seeing the business from young. But to run a business, you basically need to know the menu well, like in F&B, the menu first thing, then the costing, like how you're going to price your dishes and what kind of menu you want to design. So designing is important. And what is your selling point, your restaurant USP. So So these things from my course and management thing and seeing my dad, and like branding, marketing, you know, all these are also very important in any kind of business, even in F&B. So all these came running into my mind. Then slowly I start to, you know, see how to run a business. So starting from the menu, I discussed the chef. Then we switched some chefs, you know, whoever suit the menu. And we go about doing the pricing, revising the pricing again. And the concept of the restaurant, like what is your concept? Like for us, it's a Taste of India. So we want to sell all kind of Indian dishes. So we're starting from the North Indian to South Indian dishes. So we want to hire chef from both North and South Indian. So basically that's how we design the menu. So even every category, we have a North Indian section and South Indian section in the menu. Then we also thought, okay, a la carte, fine dining is one section, then function hall, then outdoor caterings. So there are multiple venues in F&B, so we try to, you know, target all these venues. So, and for me to understand, like, what are the challenges involved in, like, catering, first time it's not never easy thing. Like, you need to know how much to be served, for how many, what is the quantity going to be, and the setup, the buffet setup, and how many staff to be allocated there, and what are the cutleries, even disposable or melamanware, whatever is required. So all these things, you know, you need to over experience, you know. Obviously you will make some mistakes at the start, first couple of months. Then slowly when you do multiple functions, when you, for the start, I actually visit most of the events myself to see whether, you know, everything goes fine and the customer is satisfied, because in the end, it's customer satisfaction is the most important thing. So I'll just check the personal feedback of all the customers, whether they're satisfied with the service and the food quality and all these things. So for any industry, but F&B mainly is the quality of service and quality of food. That's what I believe in. In F&B itself, like it's a service-oriented business. So you wouldn't know a guaranteed sales or returns or anything of that sort. A particular month may be very peak because of multiple orders and visiting of fine dining customers. But certain months, you know, it's a low period. So it's hard to, you know, predict business in this line. I think honesty pays off. So both my parents, they always say, you know, whether you make loss or profit, just be honest. Like, be truthful, and it's very important in business. Like, getting a reputation is quite easy in business, but maintaining a reputation is very hard. A lot of people fail to maintain their reputation, because once you make a mistake or, you know, you lose your trust, people lose their reputation, and in a business field, it gets spread around, and when nobody believes in you or trusts you, you can't really do business much. So even if you are at a loss, you shouldn't make the person who trusts you to lose anything out. So you should pay them off. So that's what my dad always says. So I always feel, okay, whether you're making profit or loss, it doesn't matter. You should always be honest and truthful to the business and to the person who, you know, whoever doing business with you. For new entrepreneurs, firstly, you should have family support. That's very important. Then you should have a passion in business. Like, what kind of business? You should be very clear. You should have a clear picture. If you don't have any family background or family business, you should have some passion about a particular industry or goal. Then you should have more, you should do a lot of research, basically. How does the industry work? And who are your competitors? And if you're going to start a business, you know, what is going to be a USP? And what is the selling point? How are you going to stand out compared to your competitors? So you should have like a well-written business plan first. And when I'm seeing in the US, all the new budding entrepreneurs, they create a well-written business plan and they look for angel investors. So a lot of people are, you know, willing to see your business plan and they invest money in it. So in the way that you will be one of the director, board of director, but you won't really be spending much. So in that way, you know, your plan, your dream will come true. In Singapore, I don't see much angel investors, but you should have some funding, but you should be very clear, you know, your goal, your desire, and how your business is going to work out. As I say, you know, like you should work out what is the cost revenue analysis, and like in 5 years time, where is your goal going to be? You should have like even though you're not going to show it to someone else, you should have some clear picture of how it's going to be run so that you don't lose out. And any business, first couple of years, you will make losses and you shouldn't lose courage and back out. So you should keep pushing yourself. After 4 or 5 years, then you will reap the benefits and see the profits. So that's my, a lot of people will come into business 1-2 years, they make loss, they just leave. They don't push themselves, they don't work hard. they feel, okay, I'm seeing failure, so I should back off. I always say, you know, if you're passionate about something, you will always win the goal. So even you make loss in the start, you should push yourself and, you know, be victorious in the end. Yeah.